Chopstick Pad B has made significant progress with its successful initial test run, demonstrating its immense potential. Awesome. Along with that, advanced systems are being integrated to ensure the pad reaches full operational capacity in the near future. Firefly has successfully secured a substantial contract with the United States Space Force, which is another major milestone for the company. In a bold move toward its lunar aspirations, China, located on the opposite side of the world, has officially commissioned a critical system for the upcoming mission. Let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. While Pad A has garnered significant attention for its extensive testing protocols, Pad B has quietly made substantial progress as its infrastructure continues to grow. Following its installation on the launch tower on January 27th, the Chopstick system on Pad B has undergone several phases of reinforcement, where additional small but important systems have been gradually integrated. Among the major milestones, the actuator system was installed on February 12th, followed by the installation of the ramp system on February 17th. That same day, the lining system was moved to Pad B, possibly indicating its upcoming installation. But beyond these ongoing improvements, the real highlight came with the first functional assessment of Chopstick Pad B. That same day, the straps holding Chopstick were removed, marking significant progress in preparation for the test. That evening, the left arm of the Chopstick system made its first movement. While initially slow, showing measured performance rather than comprehensive exertion, the fluidity of its movement was remarkable. This demonstrated that the integrated system was operating as intended, offering the adaptability necessary for the operations to come. From an individual perspective, the newly developed Chopstick system appeared to demonstrate superior agility compared to the system on Pad A. In previous discussions with Everyday Astronaut, Musk revealed that the newly designed arm had been engineered to be more compact, minimizing bulk and increasing efficiency. This redesign has already shown its benefits, as the new system demonstrated greater efficiency and appeared to be more adept at detecting and managing returning spacecraft. Of course, these initial assessments mark only the beginning of our journey. In the near future, we can anticipate additional testing, including a mobility assessment for the residual arm, in addition to a more extensive evaluation of its lifting, lowering, closing, opening, and rotating capabilities. The next critical phase will involve conducting heavy-duty pressure tests, perhaps using large orange water bags to mimic the forces the system will experience during actual spacecraft retrieval. SpaceX may also use Test Tank 16 to simulate real-world conditions and evaluate system reliability. As the project progresses, additional elements, including landing pins, will be integrated. It is conceivable that the arms could be extended slightly to ensure optimal reach. Meanwhile, construction continues beneath the launch tower. Critical infrastructure elements such as the fire trench and orbital launch pad are anticipated to be installed in the near future. Both of these systems continue to develop at the Sanchez facility, underscoring the rapid pace of construction at Starbase. Another important development that will occur soon is the Pad B storage tanks. Unlike Pad A, which benefits from the proximity of dedicated storage tanks, Pad B currently lacks an independent fuel storage facility. Given the increasing fuel needs of future spacecraft models, particularly the V2 and V3 variants, building an independent storage tank for Pad B is a necessity, not an advantage. Advancements in this area have already become apparent. On February 16th, surveillance footage documented the relocation of 6 fuel tanks from NASA's Kennedy Space Center offices, with this number rising to 7 by the following day, February 17th. 5 of these tanks have been loaded onto a barge, with transportation to Starbase anticipated next month. It is noteworthy that these are horizontal tanks, suggesting their probable purpose for the storage of liquid methane and liquid oxygen, both of which are critical for Starship operations. The augmentation of the tank farm significantly bolsters the notion that Pad B will be operational in the imminent future. In light of these continual advancements, particularly in the Chopstick system, expectations are mounting regarding Pad B's prospective function in the recovery of starships. It appears increasingly probable that Pad B will be employed to capture a returning spacecraft during one of the forthcoming test flights. Although the status of Flight 9 is still indeterminate, Flight 10, equipped with significant enhancements to Ship 36, is poised to be the inaugural prototype to undertake a complete Chopstick catch. Examining the overarching timeline, Flight 8 is anticipated to take off in early to mid-March. Should they prove successful, Flights 9 and 10 are poised to occur in April and May, thereby harmonizing seamlessly with the construction and testing timetable for Pad B. Nonetheless, for this vision to materialize, SpaceX must maintain an unwavering focus on enhancing its landing protocols, ensuring consistent Super Heavy landings and executing controlled Starship touchdowns are essential milestones that Flights 8 and 9 must accomplish prior to the onset of the full reusability era. Irrespective of the precise moment, the era of swift Starship turnaround, heralded by the instant a vessel is seized by the chopsticks, approaches with increasing proximity. Imagine the thrill if Pad B's inaugural performance resulted in a successful ship catch. If you share in this excitement, express your enthusiasm by commenting "Wow" below. Subsequently, express your appreciation by liking the video and subscribing to our channel in order to remain informed about SpaceX's remarkable progression towards achieving full reusability. SpaceX has several significant developments regarding the forthcoming mission. The simulated satellites designated for Flight 8 have now been unveiled and are presently situated within the Star Factory. In terms of appearance, they closely resemble the payloads utilized in Flight 7. In the near future, the simulated payloads are anticipated to be conveyed to Mega Bay 2 for their integration with Ship 3. Following the successful execution of a demanding static fire test, S3 is currently undergoing thorough inspections in Mega Bay 2, a crucial stage considering the unparalleled intensity and duration of its recent assessment. In the imminent future, it will be outfitted with the Flight Termination System, PES dispenser, and the simulated payload prior to its deployment to the launch pad for integration testing alongside B-15. Upon the completion of these steps, the mission will stand poised for launch, contingent upon approval from the FAA. This imminent flight holds particular significance. SpaceX is poised to make another attempt at landing the Super Heavy booster utilizing the Mechazilla arms, thereby enhancing this innovative recovery technique. Although the vessel will make its descent into the ocean rather than onto solid ground, its contribution to the mission is of paramount importance. For the inaugural occasion, it will execute a simulated payload deployment, a goal absent from Flight 7. Furthermore, SpaceX will assess the spacecraft's capacity to reignite its engines in the vacuum of space, a pivotal advancement for deep space endeavors. The re-entry and landing procedures will be meticulously observed to evaluate the enhancements made to the flaps and heat shield on Ship 5-2, thereby confirming that the challenges experienced during Flight 7 have been adequately addressed. These assessments establish a foundation for upcoming missions, wherein spacecraft will target landing at Starbase utilizing Chopstick Pad B, as previously mentioned. Let us now direct our attention to another swiftly progressing enterprise, Firefly Aerospace. The company has recently successfully obtained $21.8 million in funding from the United States. Agreement originating from the United States. The Space Force is set to initiate orbital missions within the framework of the military's Rapid Response Space Program. Announced by the Space Systems Command on February 13th, the contract pertains to the Victus-Sol mission, scheduled for launch on Firefly's Alpha rocket. Although specifics pertaining to the payload, mission objectives, and launch timeline have yet to be revealed, this contract represents a noteworthy accomplishment for Firefly. Victus-Sol is an integral component of the Tactically Responsive Space TCRS program, which aims to showcase the Space Force's capacity to swiftly launch satellites in response to national security crises. This signifies Firefly's third agreement with the United States Space Force, USSF, further solidifying its position in governmental and military space operations. Firefly successfully secured the Victus-Sol contract via a competitive bidding process as part of the Space Force's Orbital Services Program 4, a versatile launch services agreement overseen by the Rocket Systems Launch Program of the Space Systems Command. Firefly's CEO, Jason Kim, underscored the significance of this undertaking, asserting that it will furnish the operational capability to maintain a launch vehicle and a space vehicle in readiness. All while we persist in executing various commercial and government missions until summoned by the Space Force. In September 2023, the company successfully initiated the Victus-Nox mission and is now poised to embark on the forthcoming Victus-Haze mission later this year. which will transport a satellite crafted by the space technology enterprise True Anomaly. This agreement represents a significant advancement for Firefly, which has garnered heightened recognition for its Blue Ghost Lunar Lander initiative. By venturing into military and government launches, the company is strategically positioning itself as a pivotal contender within the industry. With an expanding repertoire of skills and a robust history of achievements, Firefly is poised on an auspicious path to emerge as a formidable contender in the commercial aerospace arena. In the concluding segment of today's updates, China is taking significant strides in the lunar competition. The nation has been systematically introducing innovative frameworks for its crewed lunar expeditions. In the preceding year, the initial iteration of its lunar spacesuit was unveiled, alongside the introduction of innovative rover designs. At present, China has formally identified these critical components, emphasizing its strategic foresight regarding lunar exploration. On February 12th, the China Manned Space Agency, CMSA, revealed that the lunar spacesuit will be designated as Wangyu, signifying gazing into the cosmos. This nomenclature resonates with the term Faishan, which translates to flying into space, and has been utilized in the context of China's space station missions. In the interim, the rover assigned to lunar expeditions has been christened Tansuo, a designation that aptly signifies its exploratory mission upon the moon's surface. This unpressurized rover is designed to transport two astronauts during surface missions. The selection of these names resulted from a public solicitation for suggestions conducted between September and October of 2002. Alongside the development of its spacesuit and rover, China is deliberating on potential names for its crewed spacecraft and lunar lander, with Mengzhou, meaning dream vessel, and Lanyu, signifying embracing the moon, emerging as the frontrunners. These appellations reflect China's profound aspirations and strategic objectives in the realm of lunar exploration. Please provide the text you would like me to rewrite in a more sophisticated manner. More importantly, progress on these systems is accelerating. CMSA has officially announced that the Wangyu spacesuit and the Tansuo rover have advanced to the prototype development stage, with all efforts proceeding smoothly. This progress underscores China's resolute dedication to its lunar aspirations and indicates that the country has reached a significant milestone in its preparations for a human lunar landing. As China's momentum in lunar exploration accelerates, it is imperative that the United States, NASA, and SpaceX intensify their efforts to maintain their leadership in the field of space exploration. The growing competition means that every advance China makes is an implicit challenge to the United States in its pursuit of lunar exploration. However, as Artemis advances and SpaceX continues to redefine the boundaries of rocket reusability, the United States continues to have a significant advantage. If the current trajectory continues, the United States continues to be strategically positioned to achieve another victory in lunar exploration, solidifying its supremacy while countering the rising aspirations seen in China's recently designated systems. As the competition for lunar exploration intensifies, the coming years will be critical in shaping the future of human spaceflight. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode.